I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
McGregor would have done really good.
Mm-hmm. If you coached him.
No, if he had a professional boxing coach.
Is Joe Goosen trained him?
Is Joe trained him? I did, or another good coach. You know, I think McGregor would have done really good, because he did good for those few rounds.
He didn't actually have a boxing coach?
He didn't have a real professional,
So he was just sparring with the professional boxers, but that's so strange. Why would he?
You're going to have somebody that's going to teach you the techniques and you know. He survived. He did a good job.
You can't have anybody to teach our boxers.
No.
It's just like Ronda Rousey. She's never learned to box.
Ronda Rousey was the biggest fraud.
No coach.
She needed a real boxing coach. She didn't have one.
No, she's doing a movie right now with Mark Wahlberg or something.
Which one?
I don't know. Ronda Rousey.
Huh?
She's doing a movie right now.
If you were doing a movie, Ellie, and what's his name, Weinstein came and tried to touch you, would you let him? I'm curious, Ellie. Would you?
What do you think, Ricky?
Probably you would.
No.
Why not?
I probably, because first of all, I would probably knock him out.
But you wouldn't tell you, if he told you, Ellie, let me touch you, come on, man, I'll give you $2 million on the movie. What would you do?
Brandon Reels already offered me that, and I said no.
Ricky, would you for $2 million?
Hell yeah.
You got many more.
Touch me.
Ah. If you're in the industry, those guys like...
No matter what they do.
This guy just came out, you know, Crew, the big black guy who's an ex-football.
Yes.
Somebody helped grab him in a party. But the guy was like a huge agent from Wilton Morris.
Yeah.
He was like, hey, dude, what are you doing? Come on, man.
Yeah, fuck this. Let me tell you something. All these people are... Hey, let me tell you something. I think it's bullshit. I think it's a lie. I think it's a lie. All these people coming out of nowhere after 30 years.
No, I don't think so. I think it's real.
Hey, Carlos, after 30 years, all these people are coming now.
I think it's real, Ricky.
Why? How can you prove that, Ed? You've been touched?
No, I haven't.
It's okay. Just let me know. No one's going to know, Ellie. Just you and I.
I won't tell nobody.
If you know how Hollywood works, which you've been in the city longer than I have been, don't you know how the movie industry works? They're going to put you on a show.
Oh, you want to sweat?
You didn't get the part. We all know why.
You know I was an actor once, right? I was with, like, Carlos.
I saw you were in Dirt Nasty's music video.
And I came out on Resurrection Boulevard. I had a few lead acting parts, but you know, I didn't go far because I wouldn't do those shit. right, Carlos?
Wait, you really?
He got you into it?
He had a TV show for like 2 years, two seasons, I think. It was a pretty good show, it was successful, it was on Showtime.
Carlos is an actor, he's on TV and movies.
He done commercials?
Yeah.
I did Resurrection Boulevard.
Did you really? Yeah?
Cool, I think.
You did also a movie, was it Miami Vice?
No, I didn't do Miami Vice. I actually auditioned for the lead of that show.
Of who?
Miami Vice. No, Miami Vice.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I've been here
for
Miami.
Really?
The movie wasn't as good as the TV show.
But you just started training on Monday.
Are you ready?
Yeah. Okay.
You see some fireworks?
Did you train before?
No, I mean, I'm just learning. One's helping me out, you know.
Why are you just working with him? His last day of sparring night.
Is one on weight? Are you on weight one?
Yeah, he's 37. He'll be at 35 as soon as we leave.
Really,
I don't like stopping sparring like a week before the fight, like a lot of trainers do.
Let me ask you a Carlos.
You're cutting me off. Let me finish telling you real quick.
Okay,
ask him real quick before you cut me off. Carlos, you want to ask him something?
What do you guys say about the passing of Rafael Garcia? Did you guys ever meet him?
Yeah, great guy.
Cool guy. I met him many years ago, way back in the days. Wow. When Gabriel and Rafael, we used to work in some of our corners with Miguel Diaz. And then I met him here many times after that with Floyd. It's sad because that was Floyd's corner man, cut man, hand wrapping guy. It's sad. But since going back to that, since you cut me off, Ellie, what were we talking about?
Juan sparring the last day and he's on weight.
Oh, there's trainers that give their fighters a week's rest. With Juan, it doesn't really work. I like keeping Juan, even though it's really light sparring, I like him to stay sharp. So he could just have one day rest and then the next day he's like going back to spar. Yeah, so that's the way I do that with Juan.
I like to do it.
Huh?
You're at the same time.
Well?
No, you both.
Oh, Elie gives me a hard time, I give him a hard time too. Hi, Elie. Right, Elie? He cuts me off all the time. People say, why is always fucking Elie cutting you off?
He doesn't zip, no.
Oh, there you go, defending him.
You never fought Mario Lopez,
Elie? No, he's ducking me.
Wait, you go defending him.
Wait, so what was your name?
Valerie.
Valerie, so what brought you to this gym, to Tengu's Boxing?
Daddy,
who? Who?
Daddy. Oh, shit, Carlos.
No, I just saw him. I was looking for a boxing place to go, and then I just found him on the social media, and then I just came by.
So is this your first day?
No, I started on Monday.
But how's it going so far? It's been, what, 3 days, 4 days?
Yeah, it's going great. It's a good trainer.
Ricky, she said you're a good trainer.
Thank you. Thank you.
She said you made her do the CD.
Huh? She did her CD. You did the CD.
Yeah,
right?
I did the CD.
Why boxing? Why not MMA or gymnastics or another sport?
Oh, no.
Just boxing?
Just boxing, yeah.
Are you Cuban?
No, I'm not Cuban.
Oh, because everyone in Miami is Cuban.
They are, yes.
Everybody there is Cuban? When Floyd is there, is he Cuban?
Yeah. Oh, wait, who's your favorite boxer?
Who's my favorite boxer? I'm not really into, like, the boxing scene, but I would say Oscar. He's really good.
He's Ricky Funes' favorite fighter, too.
Who?
Oscar De La Hoya.
Ricky. Oscar was one of my favorite fighters.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, next
round. And you think Oscar's very handsome.
Close.
Right, Ricky? You think Oscar's a looker, don't you?
I have a picture of Oscar.
You have a picture? Let's see it.
No, not here. I have it after.
Next bell, guys.
When you were younger?
Yeah. I used to do like commercials and stuff, and he was part of the commercial.
Which commercial was that?
Oh my god, it was like a years ago. I was like,
move your feet. You're gonna sweat. You wanna sweat.
Was it cool? Was it a good day?
Oh yeah, he was great. I was very little.
Oh wow, that's kind of cool.
You
actually had interaction with
that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Remember, you gotta look out for that open, and the guy that you talk with a lot. And don't drop into the ground, it's gonna get counter. No, no, más el que haya logrado mucho. Watch out.
Yeah.
Derecha. Okay. Make it solid and do that to the body.
Reporting. Turn up the volume and just sit back. You're rocking with the best. Elie Seckbach. The wave of the future. We don't lose. Tell me what you're watching. EsNews. He came a long way, all the way from Jerusalem. Heavy on the grind, competition, he abusing them.